Okay, next subtopic is Boolean algebra. Okay, the original mathematical theory on Boolean algebra was first introduced by George Boole, an English mathematics professor in 1845. Yeah, so the basic law of Boolean algebra is equivalent to the rules of standard variable algebra, and then we have three law. Okay, for Boolean algebra: commutative law, associative, and distributive law. Okay, first law is commutative law. Okay, so this law tell you that when you want to write the expression, so you can put your variable or your product term in any place. Okay, as long as you use the same sign. Yeah, for example, kalau you tengok yang first ni, okay, a plus b also equal to b plus a. Okay, so sama je kan? So sebab dia gunakan the same sign here, which is between both variables, you are using a plus. Okay, and then so second example here, a and b, yeah, is equal to b and a. Yeah, so how you are going to write the expressions kan? So tak kira lah macam mana sekalipun boleh, as long as sign tersebut adalah sign yang sama. Okay, so kita ada several example. Okay, di sini kan, so boleh lah macam mana sekalipun you nak tulis. Contoh, kalau NOR, A NOR with B also equals to B NOR with A. Okay, A NAND with B also equals to B NAND with A. Okay, and then this is for exclusive OR, and then this is for exclusive NOR. And another last example here, A plus B plus C also equals to B plus C plus A also equal to C plus A plus B. Okay, so this is our first law. Okay, second law, associative law. Okay, so in associative law, it actually involves the usage of a bracket. Okay, so A plus B plus C in bracket is actually equal to A plus B in bracket plus C. Okay, or if you are using the sign dot or AND, A AND with BC also equal to AB AND with C. Okay, so sama je, you letak bracket kat mana sekalipun, dia akan boleh selesaikan, okay, the expression, as long as the expression is actually using the same sign. Okay, so bracket ni selalunya dirujuk kepada how we are going to solve the problems. Okay, which terms that you need to solve first, okay, before you move to the next term. Okay, so kalau dalam kes ni, kita solvekan dua term yang belakang lah. Ya, so sama juga kalau you nak solve yang depan dulu pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Ya, sebab dia sama sahaja. Ya. And the last law is distributive law. So distributive law shows you how you can expand your expression. Okay, so if you refer to both examples, so both examples is actually the post expression, right? So this is post, it's also post. So distributive law used to change from post expression to the SOP expressions. So kalau you tengok kan, kalau you perasan, this is post, right? So when you apply this law, so actually you are changing from post expression to SOP expression. So how you can apply this law? You sebenarnya you darab lah setiap variable ni. So you akan dapat lah yang ni. So sama juga yang bawah ni, you kena darab setiap satu variable tu, kena darab. Jangan tertinggal satu pun. Okay, so you akan dapat, okay, this expression. Okay, alright, so this circuit just show you the comparison, okay, between this the law, okay, which is the last law, okay, distributive law. And so ni yang asal dia. So bila kita apply distributive law, bila kita expand, you akan dapat yang ni kan. So apa berlaku pada circuit? So this is the differences between the circuits. Okay, but your last answer is actually still the same, because it is use the same expressions, right? So same goes with the second examples. So ini just nak tunjukkan expression je lah. Okay, so other than three law, yes, you also need to have another theorems. We have 11 theorems that you need to remember and then you need to understand. So all these theorems we will use to simplify the expressions. So kita ada 11 theorem. Yeah, even though you have 11 theorems, but some of the theorem is actually easy to remember. it's not hard to remember. Okay, because some of the theorem is just a simple theorem. Okay, example, you look at the first theorems. Okay, so this is the first theorem. Yeah, A and 0. So theorems 1 said that A and 0, so you will get 0 as your results. Okay, so anything that you end with 0 or anything that you multiply with 0, okay, you will get 0. So ni kan teorem yang simple kan kita belajar dalam matematik. Apa-apa value sekalipun bila you darab dengan kosong, you akan dapat kosong. So this is another to set example how you can apply these theorems. Okay. And then A here, it doesn't mean only one variable. A also can be represented by one term. Yeah. So if you can refer to this example, AB. So this is considered one term, right? This is a product term. So what will happen when AB end with 0? So you akan dapat kosong. Same goes with this example. Okay, this is another term. Okay, this is a post expression, right? So anything that you end with 0, end with, you will get 0. Okay, theorem number 2, you end with 1. What will happen to your expression? A and 1. So A and 1 is equal to A. Okay, so this is another example. Anything that you end with 1, you akan dapat yang asal lah. Contoh A, B and 1, you akan dapat A, B. A, B, C and 1, you akan dapat A, B, C. Yeah? And theorem number 3, by using another sign which is plus or or, A plus 0, you will get A. Okay, so anything that you or with 0, you will get A. Okay, you will get the same variable or the same terms. Okay, you akan dapat yang asal lah. Contohnya kalau kita tengok bawah ni, A, B plus 0, you will get A, B. Okay, A plus B plus 0, you will get A plus B. So this is the theorem 3. Meaning that when you see this kind of expression, okay, you meet this kind of expression, which is you have plus 0, so your answer will have the same value, okay, before you plus the 0. Okay, the same variable or the same terms. So all theorems here, you have 11 theorems, all theorems here, actually you can prove by replace your variable A with binary. Untuk membuktikan theorem ni. And Josh Bull ni, dia keluarkan theorem ni after dia proof lah. Dia buat proving kan. So kita pun boleh proof juga. Okay, theorem number 4. Okay, plus 1. What will happen? Okay, when variable or terms plus with 1. Okay, A plus 1, you will get 1. Okay, or B plus 1, you will get 1. Okay, so example here. Okay, A, B plus 1, you will get 1. A plus B plus C plus 1, so you will get 1. Okay, meaning that anything, okay, any value, okay, when you plus or with 1, your end result is equal to 1. Okay, either the variable is complement or not complement. Okay, A plus 1, you will get 1. A bar plus 1 also, you will get 1. Okay, so this is for theorem number 4. Okay, theorem number 5, A and A. What will happen? Okay, so A and A is equal to A, meaning that the repeated variable or repeated term. Okay, so another example is A, B and A, B. So you will get A, B. Okay, A plus B and A plus B. So you will get A plus B. Yeah? So if you refer to the last example here, A and B and C and A and B and C and A. So there are several repetition for each variable, right? So you have 3A, you have 2B, you have 2C. Okay, so this expression, when you apply theorem 5 for simplification, you will get A and B and C. So N ni, kalau dia jumpa benda yang sama lah. So, dia akan buang yang lain tu tinggal satu je. Contoh, A and A and A and A and A and B and C. And, so, lastly, you will get A and B and C. So, walaupun you ada repeated A tu sampai 10, when you apply theorem 5, meaning that you only have one value or one variable. Okay, So theorem 10, theorem 6 is actually same with theorem 5. Okay, the difference is the using of sign. Okay, theorem 5 we use and, theorem 6 we use plus. Okay, so a plus a, you will get a. Okay, so example, ab plus ab, so you will get ab. Okay, another example is a plus b plus c, so you will get a plus b plus c, so you have two repeated a. Okay, so when you apply theorem 6, you will get a. Theorem 7. So theorem 7 is actually the involve of complement value. Okay, theorem 1 until 6 is not involve the complement value, but now we involve the complement value. Okay, with, so theorem 7, a and a bar. Okay, a and a bar is equal to 0. So theorem 7 say that when you have two variable or two terms, and then one of the variable or one of the term is a complement. Okay, when you end both terms, you will get zero. Okay, so example, a b and a b bar, so you will get zero. A plus b and with a plus b bar, you also get zero. Okay, so another example, a and b and a bar, so here also you will get zero. Why? Because you have a and a bar. So di sini kan kita boleh applykan law tu, kedudukan dia tu kan, asalkan dia sign yang sama. Okay, so you boleh letak a tu kat depan lah. Contoh macam ni, akan dapat a and a bar and b. So baru nampak lah kot kan. So a and a bar is 0, 0 and b, you will get 0. Yeah, so here actually we use two theorems kan. Ni satu theorem, which is theorem 7. A and A bar theorem 7. 0 and B ni another theorems. Kan, theorem 1 tak silap saya kan. So kita applykan dua theorem, tapi last sekali you akan dapat 0. Okay. And then this is for theorem 7. Okay, so A and A bar. Okay. Meaning that a here, dia bukanlah bermaksud a ni satu variable saja kan. Di mana you boleh applykan teorem 7 ni? Asalkan you jumpa keadaan macam inilah. Di mana term yang pertama atau variable pertama ni dia tak ada complement. Okay, term ataupun variable yang kedua ni dia ada complement. So ni contoh-contoh lah. Okay, teorem 8. Okay, teorem 8. A plus A bar. So previously theorem 7 is N, right? So now theorem 8 is plus. Okay, A plus A bar, you will get 1. Okay. So example, A B plus A and B bar. So you will get 1. Okay. A plus B plus A plus B bar. Okay, you also have 1 as your result. And then this is another example, A plus B plus A bar. So last result is equal to 1. Why? Because we have a plus a. Okay, sorry, a plus a bar. Okay, so a plus a bar is 1. Okay, so 1 plus b is 1. So this use another theorem lah. So kita start dengan theorem 8 dulu. Lepas tu kita akan disertakan dengan theorem lain. Because sometimes in one expression, we start with first theorem. Okay, one theorem and then go with another theorems lah. Gabungan dia untuk dapatkan jawapan ni, kita mungkin memerlukan beberapa theorem lain lah. So, ni contoh untuk theorem 8. Okay, plus. When you have plus, so you will get 1. Okay. So, I get one example here. So, students selalunya dia confused especially bila dia nampak this kind of expressions. So, I show you. A and B plus with A bar and B bar. So student sometimes bila dia jumpa je keadaan ni, so dia dia apply theorem 8 for this kind of expressions. So dia kata yang ni ni actually equal to 1. So salah tak boleh. So kalau you tengok kenapa tak boleh, because dia tak follow format theorem 8. Theorem 8 say that A plus A bar, meaning that first without a complement, the second term must be all complement. Maksudnya kalau dalam case N ni, yang kedua ni dia kena NEN. Kan? Jadi beza ni. A, B bar dia tak sama dengan A bar and B bar. So yang ni memang you kena ingat. Tak sama. Okay, so bila you tulis ni, A bar and B bar ni you tak bolehlah apply teorem 8. Syarat dia, dia kena semua sekali. Maksudnya A, B ni kena dua-dua ni. Dia kena menggunakan NAND lah. Okay, straight line kan. So that's why A, B plus A bar and B bar is actually not same as 1. Dia bukan sama dengan 1. Sudah selalu bila saya bagi soalan, dia ada jumpa macam ni, dia pun buat sama dengan 1. So salah. So yang ni you kena ingat. Then teorem 9 is double invert. Okay, what will happen bila you jumpa double invert? A double invert is actually equal to A. So you akan dapat balik yang asal lah, yang original dia kan. Example, A, B double invert, so you will get A, B. Okay, A plus B double invert, you will get A plus B. Okay, dengan kata lain, you just remove the double invert lah. You ambil whatever yang bawah double invert tu sebagai you punya simplified. Okay, and then theorem 10. Okay, A plus B and C. Okay, A plus B and C. This is how you apply theorem 10. So ni kira macam process of expand jugalah. So A, bila you expand, you akan darab lah. Sorry, you akan tambah setiap satu ni. Okay, A tambah B, darab dengan A tambah C. So dia akan dapat yang ni lah. So this is a three example untuk tunjukkan how we can apply theorem 10. Okay, so A plus B, A plus B, C, D. So when we apply theorem 10, so you akan dapat macam ni. So kita akan pecahkan ataupun kita akan expand. First, A plus B, and then second is A plus CD. And then A plus CD, you boleh expand lagi. Jadi A plus C, A plus D. Okay? Sometimes in simplification, you boleh stop sampai sini je. Maksudnya you tak perlu expand yang belakang ni, tak perlu. So for simplification ni, benda yang you buat tu, dia mesti hasilkan suatu result, which is you can simplify. If you do the process but doesn't simplify, so you tak boleh gunalah kaedah tu. Maksudnya kaedah you tu mungkin salah lah. You kena cari satu kaedah ataupun teorem yang menyebabkan your expression is simplified. Okay? So you go for example 2. So example 2 also can be applied theorem 10. So if you notice, A plus B dia letak dalam bracket kan. So kenapa dalam bracket? Maksudnya dia nak wakilkan A plus B ni untuk A lah. Kan? Di sini sepatutnya kita ada tiga variable kan. Kita ada A, B, C. So A plus B ni consider sebagai A lah. C, D is consider sebagai B, C. When you apply theorem 10, dia akan dapat macam ni lah. So dia macam kita pecahkan. This is A, this is B, this is C. This is A, this is B, this is C. Kalau kita nak samakan dengan proses yang ni lah. So this is A, this is B, right? So this is A, this is C. So this is how you apply theorem 10. Boleh juga lah guna kaedah ni. And then example 3 yang ni yang banyak you akan jumpa nanti lah bila simplification. A plus A bar and B. You jumpa je keadaan macam ni, which is you have A, and then another term you have A bar. You terus boleh apply theorem 10. Okay, why? Because when you apply theorem 10, you akan dapat these terms. Right? Okay, A plus A bar, A plus B. So you can simplify because A plus A bar is 1. Here, kan? You akan dapat 1. And then 1 times with A plus B, okay, you will get A plus B. So you can simplify the equations. Okay. Ataupun kalau you jumpa macam ni pun boleh juga. A bar plus A and B. Yang ni pun you boleh gunakan teorem 10. Okay, you akan dapat A bar plus A, A bar plus B. Okay. So A bar plus A is 1, right? So 1 darab dengan A bar plus B. So your end result will be A bar plus B. Oops. Okay, macam ni saya padam sikit. Okay. So you will get A bar plus B. Okay, so your result will be A bar plus B. Yeah, so this is theorem 10. So ada maksud ni kenapa kita guna A, B, C. Maksudnya kalau you jumpa ketiga-tiga tu benda yang berbeza, you boleh gunakan teori 10. Dalam kes ni dia berbeza. Walaupun kalau you tengok berapa dia macam sama kan. This is A, this is A. But in algebra it's actually different because this variable have not. So kita consider benda berbeza. That's why we can apply theorem 10. And our last theorem is theorem 11. Okay, so A plus A and B. Okay, A plus A and B. So your last answer will be A. So this theorem 10 actually shows you the factorizing process sebenarnya. Okay, factorize lah. Okay, so proving dia kat sini. A plus A and B. So you factorize A. Because both terms have similar A, right? So when you factorize A, in bracket will be 1 plus B. Kan? So A times 1, you will get A. Sebab tu kalau you jumpa macam ni, A plus AB is A. Meaning that whatever yang you factorize, itulah menjadi you punya last simplified term. Okay? Contoh kalau you tengok example 1, A plus ABC. So in this case, we have similar A, right? So you factorize A. That's why your factorized value becomes your simplified term. So for example 2, AB plus ABC. So in this case, you factorize two value which is AB. Sebab dua-dua ni dia ada variable yang sama dua variable, AB. So that's why your simplified terms will be AB. So in your expressions, kalau you jumpa more than one yang you boleh factorize, you keluarkan semua sekali. Okay, contoh dalam kes ni, because dua-dua ni ada AB kan. So kita keluarkanlah AB serentak. Boleh juga nak keluarkan satu-satu, tapi jalan kerja kamu akan jadi panjang lah. Okay, so this is the factorizing. Okay, so bila you jumpa je keadaan macam ni, you boleh applykan teori 11. Right? That's all the theorems, which is we have 11 theorems. So you need to remember all the theorems, you need to understand all the theorems. Dan macam mana kamu nak gunakan teorem tu? Bila kamu boleh applykan teorem kamu ni for your simplifications? Okay? So, even though all the theorems actually akan diberi kepada kamu dalam peperiksaan, ada dalam appendix, tapi saya nak kamu faham. Sebab tak guna kalau kita letak appendix di belakang tapi you tak tahu nak apply kan? So, most of the student, bila saya tanya, kebanyakan daripada mereka sebenarnya mereka tak faham. Teorem dah ada, diberi, tapi mereka tak tahu macam mana nak guna. So, that's why you need to understand all the theorems.